Hello, I'm Mayor Craig Thurman along with Councilor Johnny Parks. We're here today to talking about the 2018 General Obligation Bond. The program's called Build Our Future Broken Arrow. For this video, we're going to talk about the project in Proposition Number 5, drainage improvements near Indian Springs. How will the drainage be improved, Johnny, in this area?
Well, this channelization, they call it the Indian Springs channelization, is a $600,000 project. It comes from the Proposition 5, and it's actually replacing a bridge across Jasper, 131st Street, where it enters South Estates Avenue on the west end of the golf course. That's a small tributary that goes into Aspen Creek, but the city and the citizens have a lot of problems with backflow, with water getting underneath that street, and so that was one of the primary projects that we heard from citizens that we needed to work with.
This project sounds like it affects a small number of people. How's it going to affect my neighborhood?
Well, and we hear that question a lot too. And in this case, it will affect the people right below there. And it's not a lot of people, but it's several houses. It also protects the Indian Springs Sports Complex in that area. What happens in Broken Arrow, probably 75% of the water drains into the Arkansas River. 25% goes into the Verdigris River water. So anytime you're able to sustain or hold this water back from flooding, it's going to help some people down. Even on the Aspen Creek, on further down, it's going to help them because we're controlling that water. To give you another example of another project on that would be the one up by St. John's. The one up by St. John's is a $3 million project. It's one of the propositions. And on that project, we're holding back water there, trying to hold water back that goes into the Hakey Creek Basin. And that would be a 9-mile stretch from the Hakey Creek down to the Arkansas River. So what the city is wanting to do and what's needed in that area is to put in two detention ponds in there and actually bore underneath the Broken Arrow Expressway and to increase that flow underneath the expressway so again that we can control the water. The law, as you know, Mayor, the law is that a person who develops can't let water go off at a faster rate than what it did before it was developed. So they have to slow this water down. And what these two detention ponds will do is give us the ability to slow water down so that we can help that 8 miles of people. So this particular proposal on all of the stormwater helps all the citizens of Broken Arrow. So we have them in all parts of town. But that's a big one there, and it's important that we do that. The Broken Arrow Expressway was built with a 50-year floodplain, so it should run over once every 50 years. That's kind of unheard of in Broken Arrow. We always look at 100, and with this change, with this expansion, it will put it at a 100-year floodplain across the Broken Arrow Expressway.
That's great. It does sound like it impacts a lot more people than what you would think.
That's exactly right.
So I know a lot of work's been done on these propositions and on this bond proposal. So can you tell us how these stormwater projects were came about?
Well, I in the years that I've been on the city council and you also, I know that nearly every item that we have come in developing, the people around want to know how it's going to affect the flooding. So in this case, it's no different. I was surprised when a majority of the people that came in were concerned about different flood areas in the city of Broken Arrow because it's just typical that we want to protect our homes. So we look at the public to get input. We looked at our own engineers, especially Kenny Schwab, who does an excellent job, very knowledgeable of the city, and a great engineer. So we look at all of this and put it together to see what would positively affect the most people in the city of Broken Arrow.
That's great. I know that staff and everyone's put a lot of work in these, and these are really very important that people get out and vote for them. Anything else you'd like to add or share?
Well, I just would say that it's our community, and we need to be involved. You need to be involved. The citizens need to be involved to keep the upkeep and upgrade of their community. So don't forget to vote on August the 28th.
I agree. It's important that everyone gets out and votes and expresses their opinion. And this is a very important bond issue for our whole community.
Exactly.
So hopefully we'll have a lot of support and a lot of people out there voting. Well, that's a wrap for this edition of Build Our Future BA. Go to our bond page to see all the projects and all six of our different propositions at www.buildourfuturebA.com. And don't forget to vote on August 28th.